Okay, so in this video I'm going to show you how to complete the square so that we can find the vertex of a quadratic equation. The vertex is nothing but either the maximum or the minimum point, and I'll show you how to find which one it is as well. So first step in the question itself, I like to put a bracket around the first two terms, the x square and the x term, and then leave the constant outside. Next, you want to factor out any a value, but since there's no a value in this problem, we're going to skip the second step for this slightly easier problem. The next step would be to take this number right here. I'm going to write it on the side, 8. You want to always divide this number by 2, and you want to square the solution. So that's just 4 square, which is 16. Now I'm going to take this number, and we're going to add and subtract it inside this bracket. So y equals x square plus 8x plus 16 minus 16 minus 5. Okay, as you've seen, I've added and subtracted the same number, so technically the equation has not changed at all. The next step that I'm going to do is I'm going to remove this negative number outside the bracket. And typically you multiply by what's outside over here, but in this case it's just a 1. So in this case it's just going to be y equals x squared plus 8x plus 16 and then minus 5 and then minus 16. So I've moved the 16 outside the bracket. Now if you've done these steps correct, this should always be a perfect square in this question. And if you don't know what perfect square is, you gotta learn it from the perfect square chapter, which is a few chapters earlier. But if you do know what perfect square is, you know that we can turn this bracket right here into x plus 4 square. And then if I just add these two terms, minus 5 minus 16 is negative 21. And that's how you complete the square to change an equation from quadratic form to vertex form. Now since this is a positive out over here, it means that it's a minimum. And the point of the minimum is always the opposite of the x value here in the bracket, so negative 4, comma, and then the y value is that value out there, negative 21. Okay, I'm going to do a couple more examples, and they are going to get more difficult as well, but same idea. I'm going to do them a bit quicker as well. I'm going to start with my bracket, no term to factor out. I'm going to write this on the side, 5. I'm going to divide it by 2. And then I'm going to square it. 5 over 2 square is 25 over 4. So now we have a fraction. So I'm going to go y equals x square plus 5x plus 25 over 4 minus 25 over 4. It's all inside the bracket. And then I have the plus 12 on the outside. I'm going to move this outside my bracket. So y equals x square plus 5x plus 25 over 4. Plus 12 minus 25 over 4. This is a perfect square right here. X plus 5 over 2 square. And then I can combine those in my calculator. So 12 minus 25 over 4. You can convert to a fraction. It's just 23 over 4. Again, this one's a positive one, so it's going to be a minimum. My x value is negative 5 over 2, and my y value is 23 over 4. Okay, going to go to even harder examples. I would suggest watching all 6 examples that I do in this video. They are all slightly different, and they are going to get harder and harder. Same thing here, I'm going to put a bracket. But now I have an a value here, which I have to factor out of the bracket. So I'm going to do that as my first step in this question. So if I take this 2 out, I'm left with x square, and that's going to turn into a minus 6x minus 4. And I take this number right around the side, negative 6 divided by 2 squared. That's negative 3 squared, which is positive 9. I'm going to go y equals to 2. X squared minus 6x plus 9 minus 9 minus 4. Same steps from now on. When I move this number out of the bracket, I'm going to be multiplying it by the term out here. That's the other difference in this question. So 2x squared minus 6x plus 9. Move this out. It's going to become negative 18 because I got to multiply the two numbers when moving it out. And final step is again going to be the same, y equals to 2. This is a perfect square. That's x minus 3 squared. That's going to give me negative 22. Again, this is a positive a value, so again it's a minimum. My x value is positive 3 and my y value is negative 22. Okay, even harder questions, I would suggest checking out these three as well. Okay, again, I'm going to start with my bracket. I do have a negative there. I have to factor it out as my first step. So y equals to negative. This is going to be x squared. This is going to turn to minus 4x minus 8. I'm going to write this number on the side, divided by 2 squared. It's negative 2 squared, which is positive 4. I'm going to go y equals to negative x squared minus 4x. I'm going to add and subtract that number. When I take out this number, I'm going to multiply it by the negative. So y equals to negative x squared minus 4x plus 4 minus 8. And then negative 4 times negative 1 is plus 4. And then finally, I'm going to do my perfect square. That's x minus 2 squared. Negative 8 plus 4 is negative 4. Now here's a question where we have a negative value here. So this is going to be a max. Anytime your a value is negative, it's going to be a max. If your a value is positive, it's going to be a min. X value is 2, y value is negative 4. Okay, let's get to an even slightly harder question. Again, same steps, going to put my bracket. I'm going to start with factoring out this negative 3. So y equals to negative 3 x squared. This is going to turn into a fraction. So minus 5 over 3x. Also, I always recommend doing fractions over decimals. It makes your solutions more accurate. Minus 2. I'm going to write this number on the side. So negative 5 over 3 and that divided by 2 squared. That's negative 5 over 6 squared, which is 25 over 36. Let's get back here. Y equals to negative 3. X squared minus 5 over 3x plus 25 over 36 minus 25 over 36 minus 2. Now take this number out and multiply it by negative 3. So y equals negative 3 x squared minus 5 over 3x plus 25 over 36. Negative 25, so I'll write the negative 2 first. Negative 25 over 36 times negative 3, that's a positive. And that's going to be 25 over 12. You can do that in a calculator if you want as well. I just did it mentally, but either way, you should get the same solution. And then I'll do the final step over here because there's no space to squeeze it in. So y equals to negative 3. That is a perfect square. It's going to be x minus 5 over 6 squared. Then if I combine these, I'm going to do that in my calculator. Negative 2 plus 25 over 12 is 1 over 12. So plus 1 over 12. Again, this is a negative question, which makes this a max. My x value is 5 over 6. My y value is 1 over 12. Okay, and final question, hardest question. They do get harder than this as well, but I'm not going to do one harder than this one. We have fractions over here. I'm going to again start with my bracket. I'm going to start by factoring out this 1 over 3. So 1 over 3 x squared minus. Now, if I want to find what this value is going to be, I'm going to do negative 1 over 4 divided by 1 over 3 in my calculator. And I just get 3 over 4. Okay, I'm going to write this number on the side. So I'll just put a little negative 3 over 4 over 2 squared, which is negative 3 over 8 squared, which is 9 over 64. Okay, I'm going to come back here. Y equals to 1 over 3 x squared minus 3 over 4 x plus 9 over 64 minus 9 over 64 plus 9. I'm going to move this out as my next step. So y equals to 1 over 3 x squared minus 3 over 4x plus 9 over 64 plus 9. And then I'm going to multiply those two things. So I'll do that in my calculator. 9 over 64 times 1 over 3. Negative 3 over 64. Okay, final step. This is a perfect square, so x minus 3 over 8 whole squared, and then I'll combine those in my calculator. And I get plus 573 over 64, just to get that in. Okay, and finally, this is positive, so I can say that it's a min. My x value is 3 over 8, and my y value is 573 over 64.